Today marks the official launch of the traditional autumn selling season in the Irish commercial property market, and indeed the launch of our latest bi-monthly report focusing on trends and transactions in the Northern Ireland market. As is traditionally the case, transactional activity paused for breath to some extent during the months of July and August. But just as we witnessed last year and indeed the year before, we're expecting a much busier second half of the year with significantly more transactional activity expected to occur over the next 6 months than in the first half. In the office sector, there were just under 90,000 square feet of lettings completed in the first half, but there are a number of large deals in legals at the moment which will see that significantly surpassed in the second half of the year. Prime rents are now £172 per square metre or £16 per square foot, and there will be continued to be upward pressure on rental levels until such time as new stock is delivered. Incentive packages for companies and occupiers has reduced noticeably over recent months as well. And thankfully, we're beginning to see some new developments starting to kick off with the development of the City Quay 2 building now under construction, which will improve the availability of Grade A stock in the city. Plans to cut corporation tax to 18% by 2020 were recently announced in the UK budget. And while this is welcome, more radical plans to reduce and give Northern Ireland autonomy to reduce their own rate of corporation tax are now looking less likely. The retail sector was also very busy during the summer months. We saw a number of new entrants coming into the market and looking for space. And indeed, we saw a number of new lettings and store openings happening. In fact, the vacancy rate has started to come down in Northern Ireland, and we estimate that the prime pitch in Belfast now has a vacancy rate of just 8.8%. Gap recently opened a new store on Donegal Place, and we're likely to see a number of new entrants at Castle Court over the coming months, including new entrants to Northern Ireland, including Shoe Kids and Yours Clothing. Skechers also opened two new stores in Northern Ireland over the summer months, one store in Belfast and another in Rushmere in Craigavon. DW Sports have also opened a new Belfast flagship and are actively looking for new stores. So there's quite a bit of activity, particularly focused on Belfast. We also saw a number of key investment transactions occurring over the summer, some off-market, some on the market, including the sale of a mixed-use office and retail building at Donegal Place in Belfast for over £14 million, and the sale of Valley Retail Park in Newton Abbey in recent weeks for just over £7 million. There's also a number of high-profile investment assets on the market, including Junction 1 and the outlet at Banbridge, which is guiding between 58 and 62 million, and Bloomfield Shopping Centre in Bangor, which has recently come onto the market, guiding in the order of 50 million. There's no doubt that these assets will generate quite a bit of appetite and interest over the coming weeks and months. We've also had quite a bit of activity over the summer in the hotel sector. The sale of the Loch Earn Hotel in Fermanagh closed during the summer, and we also saw a number of other hotels, including the Fitzwilliam Hotel in Belfast, changing hands over recent times. Most noteworthy is the increase in planning and development activity across Belfast over recent times, with quite a number of hotel and student accommodation schemes being lodged for planning. This will kickstart development activity in this region over the coming months and years. We are now approaching and entering the busiest section of the year, with quite a number of transactions due to launch over the coming weeks and months, and a very busy second half anticipated.